All right, let's talk about what is happening right now here in Washington, D.C. A lame duck president who won't concede in the election he just lost. This isn't the stuff of presidential elections. It's the stuff of a bad breakup. The ex who just won't accept that it's over, who won't return your favorite T-shirt or maybe your dog. They're texting you, or in this case, tweeting you incessantly. When you're going to bed, when you're waking up in the morning, President Trump insists it can't be over. He's in denial, asking the question, since when does the media call who our next president will be? Well, the answer, since always when it comes to modern elections, because they're following the data. And when Trump was winning in 2016, he was totally cool with that.
I'd like to take this moment to thank some of the people who really helped me with this, what they are calling tonight, very, very historic victory.
He trusted the media to call him the winner then. Now in 2020, despite the clear outcome of the election, he's insisting there's still a chance. Well, maybe his friends will be honest with him that this ship has sailed. Or maybe not. Ronna Romney McDaniel, the head of the Republican National Committee, echoing the president in a tweet that the media doesn't decide who wins elections, voters do. Except the media is just reporting what the voters have said, and the voters have been clear. They want to break up. McDaniel says the margins are razor thin, so it's too early to call. But check it out. The margins in Pennsylvania and Wisconsin are about where they were in 2016, and Michigan is a landslide for Biden compared to what it was for Trump 4 years ago when she congratulated the president after the media called the race.
We need to bring this country together. We can't continue under the divisiveness and the vitriol, and Donald Trump's going to have to lead the way.
McDaniel's relationship advice is very inconsistent. Last year, she lectured Stacey Abrams about conceding the Georgia governor's race. Quote, if Abrams actually cared about the integrity of elections, she'd concede the Georgia governor's race that she lost by 55,000 votes. Instead, she's on national TV today still thinking she won. Completely ridiculous. Maybe Senator Ted Cruz can tell the president the truth and not just what he wants to hear in this moment of rejection.
I would expect a similar process to play out here, despite the media trying to tell everyone, give up, go home, we know who we want to win. That's not how it works. We need to follow the law, and that means allowing the legal process to play out.
But back in 2016 at 3 a.m. on election night, Cruz tweeted congratulations to the president moments after the media projected him to win. And even after a nasty primary battle where Trump accused Cruz of election fraud, suggested that Cruz's wife is ugly, and falsely linked Cruz's father to the assassination of JFK, and Cruz opened his arms.
I am eager to help any way I can. I look forward to working closely with President-elect Trump.
What about Senator Lindsey Graham? Maybe he will level with the president.
This is a contested election. The media doesn't decide who becomes president. If they did, you would never have a Republican president forever. So we're discounting them.
There have been four Republican presidents in the past 40 years and two Democratic ones, and the media called those races. Also, like Trump, Cruz, and McDaniel, Lindsey Graham accepted the media's projection in 2016.
Well, make America great again, starting today.
Now, First Lady Melania Trump has privately discussed whether President Trump should acknowledge his defeat. So has his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, sources tell CNN. But Kushner is walking a fine line here, also urging the president to hold rallies pushing for recounts. Jason Miller, an aide, and Rudy Giuliani also making that argument. You know those guys, the ones who take their friends out to the bar after a breakup, trying to get him some digits and take his mind off of things. But most of the president's friends are insisting America will just come round, like former Congressman Jason Chaffetz, currently a Fox talking head.
Let's remember that counties administer this election. States certify those elections, not the national media. There is not a single state in the United States that has certified their election yet.
But like the others, he didn't have an issue hours after the media called it for Trump. Quote, President-elect Trump, congratulations. Chaffetz over the weekend went on to say this.
Donald Trump, when he won his victory speech, first thing he did was thank and honor Hillary Clinton. Joe Biden in his speech last night never even mentioned Donald Trump directly, did not thank him for his service, did not honor Donald Trump and all the success he had in this country.
Trump thanked Hillary Clinton? Well, Hillary Clinton conceded the race. Donald Trump hasn't conceded. It's the equivalent of American voters breaking up with him, but he just let that call go to voicemail. Doesn't mean it didn't happen. Doesn't mean America hasn't found someone else, at least for 4 more years.